Today we will perform several experiments that will test for some of the organic macromolecules you read about, including proteins, starch, sugar, and fat. Before we begin, I would like to walk you through the materials we will use to perform our experiments today. A test tube rack, 4 to 5 test tubes, transfer pipette, protective glasses, 3 pieces of paper bag, deionized water, also known as DI water, evaporated milk, 50% egg white solution, 1% sucrose solution, 1% starch solution, onion juice, 10% sucrose solution, vegetable oil, Biret reagent, iodine, Benedict's reagent. To perform the test for proteins, starch, and sugar, the protocol is relatively similar. To test for these molecules, we will add 3 milliliters of whatever substance we are testing to a test tube using a transfer pipette. We will then add 5 drops of the reagent, swirl to mix the contents, and then observe and record the final color of the solution. For each test we will perform today, there's a specific reagent with a known positive and negative result. We will discuss these tests in more detail, but for now, we'll begin with the test for protein. To perform the test for protein, we'll use the Biret reagent and we'll test DI water, milk solution, 50% egg white solution, and 1% sucrose solution. Before we get started, you may want to compose a results table that includes a column for the contents of each test tube, a column for the test results, and a strong title. I would label this table 1 in your work, and an example of a strong title is the test for protein. The results you will input will be the final color of the substance when mixed with the Biret reagent. Please take a moment to make an educated guess, called the hypothesis, as to which of the substances we will test today will test positive or negative for protein. For example, do you expect DI water to test positive for proteins? Why or why not? The answer is no. We do not expect this substance to test positive for protein, but there's a specific reason why DI water will be included in our test. DI water will serve as our negative control. Let's begin our experiment. I will first label my test tubes with a wax pencil. Then, I will add 3 milliliters of each substance, starting with DI water, to the test tubes. We will now add 5 drops of the reagent, Biret, to each of the test tubes, swirl to mix, and record the results. As you can see, Biret is blue in color alone. If Biret is added to the substance and the mixture remains blue in color, this will indicate a negative test for protein. However, if Biret is mixed with the substance and the mixture is purple or pinkish purple in color, this will indicate a positive result and the presence of protein. Let's work through the results of our experiment. Test tube 1 contains DI water. Clearly, the contents of this tube are blue, which indicates a negative test for protein. In table 1, under the results column for test tube 1, you should record blue. Noting your table, you only record the actual results. You will want to save any conclusions for the conclusion section of your lab report. In this case, your conclusion for this test would be that DI water tested negative for protein, since it remained blue when Biret was added. Please take a moment to record the results in table 1, and let's continue reading our results. Test tube 2, which contains milk solution, is pinkish purple in color, indicating a positive result for protein. Test tube 3, which contains a 50% egg white solution, is purple in color, also indicating a positive result for protein. Finally, test tube 4, which contains 1% sucrose, is light blue in color, indicating a negative result for protein. Please record the final results on your table. Now that you have the results for this experiment, you will want to work through each test tube and make conclusions like we did together for the water sample. I would like you to answer the following questions in your conclusion section for each substance that we tested. 1. What were the results? In other words, what color was the substance when Biuret was added and the contents of the test tube were mixed? 2. Were your results expected? Why or why not? And 3. If you find that your results were unexpected, please explain why. Indicate possible reasons for this, and also include what you would do moving forward given this result. For example, if we tested DI water for protein and found that DI water tested positive for protein, this would be an unexpected result. What would we do? Would we throw out the results of the entire experiment? Why? Water is the negative control. We know water should not contain proteins, and if it tested positive, we would start the experiment with fresh equipment, reagent, and water samples to ensure accurate results. Now we will work through the test for starch. This test will be performed in the same way as the test for protein, but with a different reagent. The reagent that tests for starch is iodine. Since iodine alone is yellowish-brown, any substance that remains yellowish-brown when iodine is added will be negative for starch. If the solution turns purple to dark purple-black when iodine is added, this will indicate a positive result for starch. In this experiment, we will test DI water, 1% starch solution, onion juice, and 1% sucrose solution. The first step in this experiment will be to label 4 test tubes and set up our second table. Please set up table 2 for your lab report. I will now add 3 milliliters of each substance to a test tube, and then 5 drops of iodine. Swirl and record the color in table 2. Let's take a look at the results. Test tube 1, which contains DI water, is light yellow in color, indicating a negative result for starch. Test tube 2, which contains 1% starch solution, is light purple in color, indicating a positive result for starch. Test tube 3, which contains onion juice, is light yellow in color, indicating a negative result for starch. And test tube 4, which contains 1% sucrose solution, is light yellow as well, also indicating a negative result for starch. Now that we've completed our experiment, I would like you to work through the same questions you were asked for the first test. Please take a moment to think about your answers to the following questions for each test tube. 1. What were the results? 2. Were your results expected? Why or why not? And 3. If you find that your results were unexpected, please explain why. Indicate possible reasons for this, and also include what you would do going forward given this result.